Welcome to a new Play Now, this time with Grip, an early access game made by some of the developers of the original Roll Cage series. It's by a studio called Caged Element, and it's in pre-alpha on Steam right now in early access for 16 euros. Again, early access, so it's not a complete game or a polished game or in any way optimized at this point. Reasons for which it may not actually run at 60 frames a second, even though the video is recorded at 60 because I tried to make it as close to 60 as I could. Graphics wise, it's got a lot of options, I gotta say. You got several types of anti-aliasing, ambient occlusions, object quality, shadows, effects, textures, post-processing, blur, which I'm gonna turn off maybe for 1-2 extra frames, and the resolution, which you can now actually change in-game. Because it's pre-alpha, you had to edit a configuration file earlier. Other options we've got here would be game options that'll let you select which kind of split screen you want. If you haven't played Roll Cage, I'm gonna do a short summary for you. It was a really good combat racing game, well, series from back around 99 and 2000. I played the second one a lot, like probably 100 or 200 hours. It was one of my favorite games ever, and because it had split screen, it made it a lot of fun to play with someone else, especially because it had a lot of game modes like combat and racing and combat racing, and it had well, if you've played Rocket League, it had that, only instead of a ball you had a giant boulder and you shot it around with missiles. Yes, the cars you see on the background basically have jet engines strapped to them, but you also had missiles to shoot that thing. Also, another thing to note is the music in the game, which is also composed by some of the original composers of the Roll Cage series, is great. It's that electronic funky feel that's just right for this type of game. Currently, there aren't that many control options because, again, pre-alpha, you can't reconfigure them, but they added this, which lets you change the speed at which you steer, which is very useful because the old version didn't have that, well, the cars weren't that steerable. Also, you don't have that many cars, there's only two. The game offers you, well, will offer you in the final version, an option to play a Grip League, which is like the Roll Cage League. Actually, it had several leagues. There was the last league over Roll Cage Stage 2 was the Aurora League. I never finished it because it had, I think it was a knockout race near the end that was just deadly because you had to make jumps into areas where it was hard. I mean, I never finished that thing. As normal game modes, you have races, arenas, playgrounds, and time trials. Here you have to beat certain times. Currently there's only three maps available, and only one of them is what you could call complete. Playgrounds is where you just run around and do just about nothing. Arenas, this is where you basically fight against other cars. Only two variants available currently. And they have, there's not much of a difference between them. In Roll Cage, you had statistic for each car, which showed you what strengths, what speed they had. And strength actually mattered because if you were running very fast and you were slamming head on someone else, if your car had high strength, you could just throw them off the track, which was kind of nice to do, especially if the track was suspended about 1,000 kilometers in the atmosphere of a gas giant or something like that. I think that was the Sky League or something. I'll get to this mode soon, but first let's try out the races. I'm gonna pick what car? Should I pick a Dreadnought or the Dominator? Let's see which one has the better color scheme. This one or... let's pick a Dominator because that has this cool fiery, well, greenish fire thing. Okay, firstly we have these three maps. This one sort of reminds me of... well, actually, they both kind of remind me of the Mars maps from Roll Cage Stage 2. Those were some of my favorite maps. I'll pick this one because being at night, it has better mood lighting. How shall I put it? Oh, should have shown you the options menu because you can set up a race and dictate exactly how many opponents you have, how long a race would last. Let's see if I can. No, that's the. You can't zoom out the camera more than this. And I can't really remember what button was used for looking back. But the enemies are behind me, and they're gonna try to kill me. I'm gonna set down a mine for them right there. And yes, someone did just bite that bullet, or bite that mine. The control right now is okay. The cars will have options such as upgrades later to make them more maneuverable. Currently equipped, I have a shield, which I'm gonna put on. Unlike the shield from Rollcast Stage 2, this one only covers the back of your ship. I keep wanting to say ship for some reason. Only covers the back of your car. Cars that can flip, in case you didn't notice, they can flip, they can rotate all over the place. And the second power up I have is the speed boost, which, yeah, kind of wasted it, but I hope I get to pick up another one because I want to show you something really nice about that power up, which I'm hoping is going to become available as a standard feature even if you don't have the power up. Okay, I'm not a very good driver at this game currently, but I will be soon. Now you're seeing a power-up that sort of looks like a missile, but also resembles the number one, mostly because this one will seek out and kill the number one player. it's a really nice feature. To help me actually play better, I'm gonna activate the slow motion mode now. This was a power-up in the previous game. Currently it's a feature which I can activate with a single button. I'm sort of stuck riding this rail right now until I collide with that fence. Yeah, not a very good thing to do. Okay, come on. Oh, I actually hit someone. Nice, nice. Okay, let's target that guy. Not a lot of power-ups in the game currently. There are planned a few more. I hope they actually had more than they have planned, because well, the old game had a bunch of them. Ooh, I actually hit and killed someone with that mine. Nice. I enabled the option that lets you kill people with weapons in this one. It's just a racing, normal race mode. Rollcage had a combat racing where you weren't scored on what... Well, in the league, you got the score on the race. Not only on the position you had, but also on how much destruction you caused along the way, either by hitting opponents or by destroying the scenery. Currently, the scenery isn't that destructible. It's mostly stands there. You'll probably be able to hit it with that cluster missile that's promised on the official site, the weapon loadout thing. And bam. Yeah, not a lot of destructible environments currently, but that's okay. They'll add it more. Again, it's pre-alpha. They'll add it later. Okay, let's get back on track. The game is currently, well, it's what I expect it to be. It's not perfect yet. Again, pre-alpha. There's still some fine-tuning to do with the cards, the controls, more power-ups, more destructible stuff. I mean, this stuff should be destructible. This stuff I should just be able to... Actually, I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna try to just slam in this one of those pole things at maximum speed and see if it... Did it fly off? I just saw myself flying off. No, I think it's still there. Okay, so I'm gonna power up. And you can see in front of the car, there's a... Well, no, you can't see it. Must have been on the other car. The basic idea is that cars in Rollcage, once you got around above 400 kilometers an hour, they had this really, really neat fire effect on the front, as if they were basically re-entering the atmosphere at maximum warp, maximum speed or something like that. It gave a really great sense of speed before motion blur was a thing. I still like it more than motion blur as a way of representing speed in a video game about cars and racing. The tracks have multiple branching paths. I could have gone back that way through that small tunnel. Or I could go through here. The other way was a bit faster, but... well, actually, I don't actually think there are any downsides to it. Most shortcuts in Rollcage had a downside to them, because actually getting to them may have been difficult. There was a similar tunnel on that one of those sky levels that you could only hit if you were previously riding separated walls that lined the track, because the track was... There was a track floating in air, and it had walls from place to place, not connected, to themselves, which you had to ride on very carefully to get up there. Also, I don't see currently the double power-up feature working. I don't know if it's active or maybe it isn't. The idea was that if you could, if you would pick up the same power-up twice and you already had the power-up in the second slot, it would amplify the existing power-up and make it stronger, faster, better, more violent, more destructive. And I'm gonna probably find that last racer and blow him up and maybe win that way. Because this is the... Oh no, he won. He won. He's just... Yeah. I don't know if I can blow him up. No, he... Did he just stop? He just went backwards. For some reason. Did he stop in front of the finish line? Might have. Okay, currently the game is running about 35 frames a second. I'm running on a measly... No? Looks like the entire... Is that thing moving? I'm not sure if it's moving anymore. Okay, the enemy dropped off the map. Yeah. Yeah, I think the tracker was a bit bored, so it didn't probably show my position. Okay, so I'm running this on a GTX 750, which isn't a very good video card. It's an okay card. But not really meant to run games on high. That's what I'm saying. Let's try some of the other modes with another car. I'm gonna... let's pick the arena and that festive map with the dreadnought. Let's see which one. Yeah, this one. Setup. This is where you can see exactly what kind of stuff you can do. I can put the engines on wild, which means they're gonna go a lot faster. Enemies on hard. Combatants 10. This is gonna probably drop the frame rate a bit more, but that's okay. Engine panda, yes. Yeah, the wild engine may introduce some gameplay problems because it's wild. It's uncontrollable. It's danger. It's the danger zone. We're gonna play in the danger zone. A very festive map. Currently, the combat arenas are, well, I don't like them that much because they're too open. What I liked about the combat arenas from Roll Cage, Stage 2 especially, was that they were mostly circular and you could ride on walls. There was actually one arena which was horizontal, as in you had to go up, sort of like the planet Halo. It was an artifact name. A ring world, basically. It was on vertical. So you had to reach a certain speed before you could actually go anywhere, or else you just fall off the map. It was quite fun to play in split screen. Now let's kill some people. We have the Scatling Gun, which has a bit of an auto-aim. What I would have loved to see was a more defined firing projectiles for it, because currently you can't actually see them, but you can hear them impacting. I kind of love the sound design in this, because I'm gonna get close to that mine. I just hope they don't run over it. You can actually hear the mine ticking away as you get near it. Louder and louder. It's a neat feature. You can also hear the missiles when they come for you. So that's a missile. Yeah, that was a missile. And I'm at half hit points. Half health. Let's enable that shield. Now this is a game mode where that full shield from the previous game would have come in handy, because you can be hit in the front by a missile or a Gatling gun. There's currently a lot of power-ups missing, so you don't have that explosion charge, you don't have that thing that made you run really fast and electrocute people around you and slow them. Actually, you froze their tires or something like that. You don't have the teleporter. I actually asked the developers if they were gonna add the teleporter, and they said probably not. Mostly because it causes a lot of violent episodes if you're playing in split screen, especially in those knockout races where you could just teleport in front of the enemy. That was okay. Maybe not the most balanced thing you could have in a game, but it was fun to have. Okay, I just got hit in the face really hard by... Wait a minute, I didn't fire any missile. Oh, strange. Must have been hit by a missile in the front and the explosion killed someone else. Now there's just me and that guy. The AI currently, I haven't set it on. Okay, then mine. Haven't set it on high. If I set it on high, they will just converge on me and hit me with missiles at every opportunity possible, which is nice to have. A nice feature. The game is made on the Unreal 4 engine, and you can tell this really easily because it has this really dumb effect. I mean, come on, this is blinding me. My eyes aren't a camera. If I was piloting this from the cockpit and I actually had the windshield in front of me, yes, it makes sense to have that effect, but this is just annoying. It makes me want to wipe my monitor, and I probably should do that soon, but it won't fix the problem. I really hope they disable this in later versions because it's annoying. Also, just as annoying, I'm gonna let myself be hit in the face by a rocket, just so I can show you. Enemy, come on, come here. Enemy, Mr. Combat, who are you? Top doesn't show their names. Okay, where is the enemy? Where did he go? Mr. Enemy, come on! Okay, come on! You can hit me, you can do it, come on! Hit me in the face! Hit me in the face! Okay, I like the fact that the cars now will sort of throw off flame and smoke when they're badly hit. What I don't like is that when you're badly hit, your HUD goes haywire. It's a bit annoying to the eyes. I really don't like it. I hope they had the option to disable that, the damage effects on HUD. I guess it's a bit annoying. Well, come on, stand still for a second so I can hit you in the face with a rocket. And I think, yep, they improve. Okay, I also like the fact that it fires automatically every weapon you have when the game ends. That's a nice feature. Also, would like to see these camera options when the game is completed. Currently, you can only change the camera by that a bit. Zoom in, zoom out. Yeah, that's basically how the game used to end in Rocky Station. The car would just drive on and just slam into everything it could. And now it can even reset. As you can see, it's a very detailed game when it comes to cars. It's not running on full detail yet because, again, not a very good video card and it's not that well optimized, but you can still see it's well made. The trailer they showed for the Kickstarter, which sadly failed, but it's still on early access, showed the detail that's actually available in the game for most of the part. It was quite impressive. I mean, that trailer, if you haven't seen it, it basically shows you what the game's about in a few short seconds. It's amazing. Also has a how to play thing, yes. EMP, they're gonna add it soon. Dang. I'm actually glad. Quaker, that's the mine, the Aegis, the Firestorm. Grip control, very heavy, their fast, yes. Weapons and power-ups. I really hope they add more of these because they're quite fun to have. Okay, let's pick a different map for racing. I'm gonna try the Yuri Industrial one. And which car? Currently, I don't think there's that much of a difference between the cars. What I like is that they have these options to tweak. I'm gonna disable destructible vehicles. Gonna keep this difficulty medium because I don't want to be just floored by them. Yeah, they should be right. They should be right. You can mirror them, you can reverse the tracks, which makes them a lot more fun in the long term. Okay, let's do this. And selected and race. Not really that much to say in terms of feedback about the game currently, mostly because they plan on adding a lot of things to it. So most of the stuff I want them to add, they've already said they're going to add. I'm really, really glad. Okay, I took the other way. Again, that was a destructible bit, which didn't explode. They should have some explosive, really big explosion effects on destructible bits. I think the columns on that earlier part of the tunnel were destructible. Let's see, take the roof. Okay, we're going a bit fast. Yeah, that stuff should have broken. In the old game, stuff like that would break off. Okay, yeah, this is the stuff I was talking about. See, the HUD tends to do that, not only when you're hit, but also when you're on low health. Sorry, English isn't my first language, and some of the pronunciations of the letters are a bit at some point. Currently, the cars also tend to sometimes get stuck in the ground. I mean, one of them actually got stuck in the ground, have the tires in the ground and the front tires in the ground. I mean, it's what's a bit funny, but kind of sad. The poor guy didn't see that missile coming because he said it was in the ground. It was like an ostrich. And yeah, that effect, I think the effect of... okay, that's it. I just saw a bit of it. There's a heating effect at the front of the car. It's very nice. Okay, let's go through this one. Shortcut. I'm gonna hit that. That little bit should have been distractable. Those bumps are nice, but why is that guy... That... You saw that. Okay, okay, I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go back. And... No, no, no. Go back the other way, back the other way. Can I even go back the other way? Because there was some guy stuck up there. Okay, it's not stuck up there anymore. Did I loop past that? Is that part of the map? I mean, the upper part. Because you saw it. There were... The rocket was tracking someone stuck up there. Okay, I'm gonna need to explore that more. I don't think you got up there by traversing the map. Okay, let's pick up some power-ups. Okay, come on, come on, come on. Okay, I want to try... Yes, they're destructible. They don't explode. I'm not sure if it's because I'm running this on less than full detail or because they don't explode, but some explosive effects for them would be nice. It would just make them easier to see that they exploded, that something... That it's more spectacular, more... flashy, if you will, when they explode. Also, currently no trackable terrain for the missiles. This is just an anti-personnel missile, basically. It's not, it doesn't track scenery, just other cars. Come on, I can do it, I can do it. Yes, there's a car, yes, there's a car. And I, the camera tends to go a bit flippy often when you get too close to the edges of the track. Come on, let's go. Fire it up, fire it up, fire it up. Okay, shield. Kind of pointless that I'm now that I'm behind everyone. But let's activate it anyway and hope for the best. Machine gun, not a very big radius. Big range, I mean, for it. Okay, I have no idea what I did there. I just sort of teleported after I hit that thing. Ooh! Did... Yeah! Okay, so there's a part of the scenery here that's destructible, and I think that was what the missile was tracking. So yes, the missile can track the scenery, and someone blew it up behind me. Okay, so yes, I stand corrected. Missiles can track scenery, just not a lot of it. That's good to know. Let's see what else it can track. That's a player. Let's go after that player. Well, it's an NPC, not a player. It's a player character. No, it's an opponent. It's a car, not a piece of scenery. Did that just regenerate? No, probably didn't. Yes, I see. Now you can see it clearly. That's that hitting effect in the front of the car, which is fantastic. I love it. I'm really happy they added it because it's just amazing. Okay, yeah. Yeah, that's one of the reasons I never finished the Aurora League. I keep missing jumps and hitting things like that. Not really something you want to do when you're trying to finish the hardest league in the game. There's a missile. Yes, I hit him in the face and I hit myself in the face with a piece of the giant rock. Okay, Talon got hit by Jetfire or the other way around. Yep, I'm gonna lose this race, but still, it's a nice track. Very nice track. It's the most complete of the set currently available, and this is why a full shield is needed, because with a full shield you could step over that and be okay. With this shield, no, you can't. Okay, then bam. Now the game to you may not be as impressive currently because we've had games like, I don't know, Split Second and some other stuff recently. Like, there was also the... I forget the name almost. I forgot the name, which is a shame because it was a great game. God damn it. How could I forget the name? It's Green Carnage, I don't know. Gas Gutter, yes, that was it. Gas Gutters. And the expanded version was Combat Carnage or something like that. Which is also a very good. A very good combat racing game. Which also had stuff like destructible terrain and shortcuts. Okay, I'm gonna be hit by a missile, but it's okay because I have the shield and it actually gave me a speed boost. Thank you, opponent. Okay, come on. Okay, I have two missiles now. Well, let's see if I can. Yep, I hit that missile right in the. Ah, damn it. Okay, so that part was indestructible, but I at least can hit the number one player in the face. Everyone else already finished, now they're just doing their victory tour. I'm just sitting here trying to finish the lap, which I can probably do soon. The scenery looks fantastic. I mean, the skyboxes alone look great. It really has a nice futuristic feel to it. A bit of texture popping, well, model popping, but that's okay again. Running it on a really low spec video card. Yeah, the AI it seems to know exactly how well I drive, so it just won't try. It gave up. Okay, let's play with the playground map now, which is kind of incomplete, but it's still okay. Let's pick this one. Setup, not really that much to set up. That much to set up, so let's start. Don't forget to break. Yes, breaking in the game is actually important. And this is the kind of stuff you'll see. The kind of things that can be done in the game. You've got half pipes, you've got stuff like this. You can basically jump from there to there, from one pipe to another. Yeah, again, physics isn't really completed yet. I'm sort of stuck with my car a bit in the ground and can't seem to shake loose. Yeah, that sometimes happens. Remaining, I have to pick up these little power-ups. It's sort of a training level for learning how to drive and things like that. It'd actually be nice if they had sort of Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2. Well, probably more games have it than that, but scoring system for doing tricks. But that's not really what Roll Cage was about. Still, this map really makes me want to make a kickflip. Wonder if I can kickflip the tires. Probably can. Come on, let's grind that rail at least. No, couldn't grind the rail. Okay, that went better than expected. I made it up here at least. And there's a trampoline up there. No, there's a ramp. Skies seem a bit lower res up here, but still the clouds are moving, which is an impressive feat. Let's get down again. I sort of got stuck in the ground there for a while. And I picked that up, and yeah, you can see the car got stuck in that half pipe. And again, this map isn't final in any way. The other ones are a lot more stable. Just once in a while they have those slight glitches. This one seems to happen more often, which is okay. I mean, it's a test map, it's a pre-alpha game, and it's a test map. I really hope they don't have that powerful direct in your face sunlight effect in the final version, because again, Unreal Engine, well, the people at Epic Games have some funny ideas about how to implement screen effects in their games and their engines. The ideas, well, they're funny in the sense that haha, that wasn't funny, haha. If you remember the Samaritan demo for Unreal Engine 3, you couldn't see anything in that demo. It was just darkness, lens flares, screen effects, and more darkness. You couldn't see a thing in it, and they're doing something similar with Unreal Engine 4. I just hope they don't overdo it, that the effects are removable. There was also Assassin's Creed Brotherhood that had a really annoying effect that was just like this one. So, like staring in the front of the sun constantly, and stood there just non-stop at the top of your map. It was annoying as hell. I'm glad the multiplayer didn't have that. Well, not really much I can say about the grip at this point. It's shaping up to be the game I was expecting it to be. Well, ignore this. This is just a small bug. It happens sometimes. It's not a big issue. It's on Steam, early access for €16. It has two-player combat and split screen, which is something you don't see very often in games right now. No online multiplayer yet. It's gonna have it. Again, it's pre-alpha. It's gonna have a league. It's gonna have more single-player modes, more cards. Cards that you can upgrade, actually. It's gonna have a bit of a story in that league. And, well, it's gonna be the Brawl Cage Stage 3 game I never got. And really hope I would have gotten soon. But I'll get this one and it's gonna be fine. And that's about it. See you next time. Not really sure it's gonna be next week next time. I'm gonna try to see if I can make a new show next week. Basically, these aren't on a schedule, so I'll have to find time for them. Which is kind of not really that easy considering I have to work a lot during the week on clickbait, basically, which passes for news in some places right now. Not really proud of them, but hey, gotta pay the bills somehow. Or you could sponsor this channel and, buy my book and I don't have to write clickbait anymore. As you can see, that's Corkery. You can actually drive on it. I'm probably not gonna be able to drive on it, but... Okay, let's try it. At the end of the show, let's try and drive on that corkscrew. Let's see if it works. And I failed miserably, but at least I tried. Well, that's it. Try this game if you're interested in this kind of racing game. It's rough now. It's in a rough state, but it's gonna get better. Again, the game is called Grip. It's on Steam and it's available for €16 on early access. Have fun and goodbye. If you enjoyed this show, hit the like button, subscribe and share it with your friends. Or, if you thought it was horrible, then share it with your enemies and make them suffer. We shall be your weapon of vengeance. But if you liked what you saw, you could, I don't know, maybe donate, because basically YouTube is horrible at revenue, by using the link in the description, or just buy my book. It's a fantasy book about, well, a lot of stuff. I guarantee it won't suck, and if it does suck, you can find me here and complain about it.